Guy, hi. Hi, Tanya from Absolute Radio. Congratulations on the movie.
Thank you very much. Yeah, look, it's great. It's turned out really well, and it's a real honour to be part of it. So, very happy.
Looking very handsome this evening.
Thank you very much.
Very different to your character. How long did it take to, for makeup? It must have taken quite a long time.
It was a 5-hour makeup job, and that might have just been because we were busy listening to all sorts of music and taking our time, but it was quite an intense process.
And how excited are you for fans to watch the film? For those of us, I saw it last night and I loved it in 3D, spectacular scenery. For those fans who haven't, of course, seen it yet, just tell us, tell them what they're in for.
Oh, I think they know what they're in for. They're not going to hear anything from me that they don't already know they're in for. I mean, it's a spectacular story. It delves into some very big questions about humanity and perhaps where we've come from. So, I think the fans know what they're in for already.
Why do you think there's such a buzz around this film?
Ridley Scott.
And what's it like to work with him?
Brilliant. He's brilliant. Well, I thought it was great. I mean, I thought it was very well written, and I thought it delved into all sorts of great big questions that, I was surprised, actually, that this kind of story hasn't been brought up before, to be honest.
And what did you feel when you first looked your aged Waylon look after special makeup?
I'm not sure. I mean, it was a long process of trying to put it all together, so I'm not exactly sure how I felt,
Scott Pearce.
Nice to meet you.
How do you do? My long lost brother. Right?
So Peter Weyland in the Alien universe is sort of considered an evil villain. Do you feel that he's misunderstood and really explored in this movie?
No, I don't feel that he's misunderstood. I mean, people have their misconceptions about, their conceptions about people and their ideas about people. And, I tried not to take on board too much of what the historical perspective of Weyland actually was, and just try and concentrate on the character that Ridley offered up on the page and what we talked about. So, I didn't really sort of delve into that too much.